Sawasdee ka. Welcome to Thailand Today here on MRT World. The Blue Line train is offering free travel between the five new stations during a two-month trial run that started on July 29. Transport Minister Saksiyam Chitchop said commuters can ride free of charge on the section between Wat Mangkon and Tha Phra until September 28. The other three stations on the route are Samyot, Sanam Chai, and Isarapap. Sanam Chai is delicately decorated to be one of the most beautiful subway stations in the country. The extension of the Blue Line MRT will stretch from the previous terminus at MRT Hua Lamphong to western suburbs in Bang Khae district. However, the test run will only run through 5 of the 11 stations along the extension, terminating at Tha Phra intersection in Bangkok Yai district. Ride tests will operate daily for free starting July 29, which is also the substitution for His Majesty the King's birthday, until September 28, but will only run from 7 a.m. to 9 p.m. At MRT Hua Lamphong, passengers will have to transfer to another train to continue down the extension. The line extension is operated by Bangkok Expressway and Metropix under a concession from the Mass Transit Authority of Thailand. The line will be officially launched on Mother's Day, August 12, running from Hua Lamphong to Tha Phra. The service will be extended to Lak Song Station, the last station on the route. The Minister of Transport officiated at the trial runs of the MRT Blue Line Hua Lamphong Bang Khae extension, on which passengers can ride the extended route for free from August 12th until 28 September this year from 10 a.m. until 4 p.m. daily. The Minister of Transport Saksiyam Chitchop dispatched the first metro train to run on the public trial of the Hua Lamphong Bang Khae extension of the MRT Blue Line, which is now accepting passengers on public trial runs to celebrate the auspicious occasion of His Majesty the King's 67th birthday. Passengers traveling from the existing MRT Blue Line network between Thao Phun and Hua Lamphong stations will have to change trains at Hua Lamphong station to continue their journey on to Wat Mangkon Tha Phra extension. Fares currently exempted for stations on the new extension and will only be collected for parts of the journey involving the existing network, starting at 16 baht up to 42 baht or up to 70 baht for connecting journeys with the MRT Purban line. Passengers can use their existing MRT reroadable fare cards or fare tokens obtained from ticket vending machines for rides. Each journey will have a maximum time limit of 180 minutes starting from the tap of card or token at the ticket gate. The Ministry of Transport's Mass Rapid Transit Authority, MRTA, and Bangkok Expressway and Metro, BEM, plans to open the Thao Phun Tha Phra extension of the MRT Blue Line in 2020, which will be the final section of the Blue Line network that will run in a circle with Tha Phra station serving as an interchange. The MRT Blue Line network will provide connections to other modes of urban transportation, including rail and water, providing passengers with a more convenient commute and helping to solve traffic congestion in Bangkok, and will be a significant milestone in public transport development to help improve their general public's lives. Mother's Day is on August 12th this year. Has been picked for the official launch of the MRT extension service from Hua Lamphong to Tha Phra before expanding to last station a month later. Deputy Transport Minister Chapairin Chu Chotsawon said the official launch date of the Blue Line extension from Hua Lamphong to Tha Phra has been set for August 12th. Trial runs will start in July, according to the Mass Rapid Transit Authority of Thailand, MRTA. MRTA Governor Pakapong Sirikanthramat said the Tha Phra Lak Song section is scheduled to open in September this year. The Hua Lamphong Tha Phra section is part of the extension to Lak Song. Another extension from Thao Phun to Tha Phra will be operated by Bangkok Expressway and Metro PIX under the concession of the MRTA. It is expected to open in March next year after a test run starting December this year, Mr. Bang Khae said. The MRT Blue Line, now running from Hua Lamphong to Thao Phun for a distance of 21 kilometers, serves 350,000 passengers a day when all extensions are completed. Its ridership should more than double to 800,000 a day. The long-awaited MRT Blue Line extension from Hua Lamphong to Bang Khae has begun, offering free rides through five new stations starting July 29, 2019. The free rides will run daily from Wat Mangkon to Tha Phra station for 2 months. So next break, we will lead you to Sanam Chai station and we'll talk with Mr. Vithaya Punmongkol. He's the deputy governor of MRTA. Coming back after a short break.
MRT World, an English language television channel in Thailand.
Authoritative sources for all government information.
High standard content that's reliable and accurate across every platform.
Our mission is to reflect the vision of Thailand.
Keep up to date through our application or website by searching for NBT World. NBT World, a vision of Thailand.
Mr. Vithaya Punmongkol, he's the Deputy Governor of the Mass Rapid Transit Authority of Thailand, MRTA, at Sanam Chai Station. So this station has been talk of the town, which has been very popular. So when the MRTA opened the station for media and public viewing of the splendid interior design earlier this year. So the MRTA Deputy Governor will talk with us about the free service of the MRT Blue Line extension. And then he will be our honorary guide to lead us to explore the full, well-designed and elaborately ornate metro stations. Sawadee ka. Well,
thank you for coming.
Well, this is one of the... It has to be splendid, as I said. But because of... How many tourists have been visiting? Some foreign tourists have been here?
Actually, since we have opened for the free ride, demonstration ride, since July 29th,
yes.
Today I think we have 40,000 passengers. Ooh. Every day for the extension part.
40,000?
But only for this station.
Okay.
We have a few popular stations. We have more than 10,000 per station.
Yeah, I have no doubt about this. Now, when we talk about Blue Line, how it runs, How it runs? Running from the route?
Actually, the whole Blue Line, we combine the existing one and the extension.
Yes.
So the total Blue Line is going to be 38 stations in total.
Oh, huge.
And 48 kilometers long.
So everything will be opened, part by part.
That's right.
It won't be. Now, test run is Sanam Chai 2.
The first part from Hua Lamphong to Tha Phra, five stations. And then we open another two stations to Bang Wa. And we're going to open the rest of the section 2 station to Lak Song. That will be all for section 2.
Tell me, who is the brainchild of this? What do you think about this?
We are the authority to implement the line. But we have the order from the National Environmental Board.
You're forced to.
The board set up the regulation for us in the EIA report that we have to decorate or make the station appearance to be harmonized with the surrounding.
Like as if you are in the museum or, you know, even in the palace, I mean the Grand Palace. It is just like that in certain parts. Beautiful, beautiful, really. So what are the feedback, sir? Feedback of the people or the tourists who are here?
I think so far so good. As I said, we have more than 10,000 visitors a day.
Mm-hmm. They're visiting this part or they are traveling?
Actually, they taking pictures. Everyone who try the extension part, they have to stop over this station to taking pictures.
It's a must. It's a must. It has become tourist destination. Right. Not only Thai, but foreign people also. It's this is in the world, we can never see such a, what do you call, decorated, ornamented, right?
I would say this is the most beautiful station in our project.
In the world?
Maybe.
It's beautiful. So the importance of the Wat Mangkon extension from the Hua Lamphong to Tha Phra, you see, so how important is this like? Why do we have to have this, the blue line to the Tha Phra?
We try to open as soon as possible for the public.
Oh.
That's why we separate the operation into three sections.
Mm-hmm.
The first section already opened from Thao Boon to Bang Sư,
what first already.
And we're gonna open the section two,
Hua
Lamphong to Tha Phra, and then the last one, Thao Boon to Tha Phra. It's important that we have to open the section two. If we not open this one, we have to wait for the whole section completed, and it's gonna be too long for waiting.
I believe certain part to have underwater. It go really under the water and come up?
Since it's an underground system.
We have to
go underwater.
We don't know that which part.
We don't know because we go under the soil.
We
can't see the water.
We cannot?
Inside, no.
You should have made it like a kind of translucent.
Aquarium-like.
We could thought so, you know. That would be, drastic. It would be nice. But now, since just for the audience or the tourists, you know, they may imagination that when they get into the water, it means down to the water. No, it's like that. But you don't feel it.
No, we don't feel it. It's just like a normal depth as we travel along the line.
So what are the how about the other extension?
Section 3, right?
Yes.
Section 3, we're going to open by the end of this year, and we're going to open fully operated early next year.
I'm looking forward to see that. So, what is your expectation? Expectation?
Ridership? Actually,
Expecting,
we have the blue line extension combined with the blue line. It's gonna be doubled up in length of the existing one, as 48 kilometers, as I said. And so I expected the ridership is gonna be doubled as well.
Double.
So today we have 400,000 passengers a day.
800,000 a year.
That's what I expected.
I believe how about the fare?
The fare, if you ride the existing line, you will be paid just like that, just like the same fare as we pay for the existing line. We have 38 stations in total, but you pay only 12 stations in maximum.
Oh, cheap. You have to add a little bit the pricing.
Not really.
Not because the beauty. They see like, you know, it's not normal.
That's the value added to the price.
Exactly, sir. It's a value added for such kind of thing because I've seen, you know, we've been here for a few minutes. We could see people coming for photographing and all that. Yeah. So that's another enjoyable.
We don't charge
for that. We don't charge. Free of charge for that. So this is the plan that other part, like we are heading to from here, we're going to go to Wat Mangkon, right?
Yes.
So that's another beauty,
right?
Another different part because of Chinese. How is it going to be?
That's, I think, is the most popular station.
Oh, really?
Yeah,
more than this
one.
Oh,
How? Because that station is in the heart of Chinatown, Wat Mangkon, Kamalawat.
I cannot imagine how
everyone
they come
goes
up
to Chinatown for
right
food, for praying,
buying gold.
Many activities.
I cannot imagine now. I'm standing here and it's so congested. How did it come up?
A little bit.
Yeah?
Yes.
We have to clap for MRTA to be working so hard to have it done, all this kind of thing. Yeah. So how about the people around here? How do they feel about having the digital station with them?
I think they look happy. They're happy to have the trains away, a few steps away from their home. Mm-hmm. They can ride the train very often.
Mm-hmm.
They can visit very beautiful stations, mm-hmm, taking pictures.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of smiles all over the stations,
mm-hmm,
because we have many nice places to take pictures. When everyone say cheese,
yes,
and smile, so that's why it smiles all over the places.
But you said free period. So how long? It's going to be free how long? 1 year? Too long for that, right?
Too long. Actually, we will go for the fully operation,
mm-hmm,
at the end of September,
mm-hmm,
this coming September.
This coming September. That is great. So from then, they will start charging. So normal charge is how much? Normal, after free.
As I say, same price as usual, everywhere.
That you normally distinct, yeah.
Maximum would be 42 baht.
42 baht.
From 16 baht to 42 baht.
So people can go around. And you have this is our audience, maybe for those who really age. Your payment will be reducing or something like others?
Actually, we have some promotion for different kinds of people. Like seniors, they're going to have a half price first. And for students, they're going to have, I think, 10% discount on the price.
You heard that. If you're a student, you get 10% entitled for reduction. And for the ages, senior citizen, you can get like what?
Half
of the price. How long did you take to build this, to have it done?
At first, we planned to have it done in 5 years.
Yes.
But we have faced some difficulties.
Mm.
So we start the project since 2011,
mm-hmm,
and until now almost 10 years.
But we don't feel it.
9 years.
Yeah, but worth of it, right? Since this is a historical area, when you know the glimpse or the charm of it is you found something which is a historical. It's just
right,
like historical site.
Right.
What did you find all that? Some of the.
We have found some items from the past, from the old times, coins.
Oh, coins!
The coins, the ceramic dolls.
Really?
Maybe Chinese ceramic dolls. Kitchenware. And many kinds of.
Excited stuff. For those who really found it. How did they report? We found it.
The Department of
Fine Arts.
Uh-huh. Fine Arts, they supervise us during the excavation.
Really?
So
oh my God.
The department take care of that already.
Uh-huh.
And later we're going to have them exhibit it in here, in the station.
Better.
We reserve some place to
great. And you can draw more. The tourists become more because this is the real. They are, you have what you call develop old historical place into new modern world to go along with it very nicely, right? Very beautiful, yeah. Mm. So the what expect for people to come here is to come more and more to make use of it,
right?
Right. And this thing. So well, this is what we see from now on. So any historical while building up this one, is there any encounter or anything experience for the people for the team?
Okay, actually we have come to the historic zone.
Yes.
Like
yes.
Heritage zone.
Heritage
area.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
So we have to introduce the new thing, like our system,
yes,
to the old communities.
Uh-huh.
So we have to get along with them.
Yes.
That's why we provide some special design for the station. Each station have its unique design, exterior and interior. If you stop over the Samyang station, for example, you will find the three buildings above ground. We decorate them as old style shop houses,
really?
In the Sino-Portuguese style. That area is the old trading zone. District.
The trade,
since King Rama the Sixth.
And then, so Samyang, we see that. Okay, we see historical here at Sanam Chai. We see commercialized area at Samyon. And then from there, reach Mangkon. And the Mangkon, so we see some gold drawing or something, gold shop. Very interesting. I'm really looking forward to see that and so excited to see that. And so we'll you have to take me, all right?
Oh, sure.
Be, okay, so we are coming to the end of the first part of our interview. So next, we'll appreciate the artwork and architecture that reflects the history and cultural roots of the local communities around each station. Please stay tuned.
In 2019, Thailand is ready for ASEAN chairmanship, working together and building solidarity to increase competitiveness and innovation with the people at the center. All sectors are ready to promote unity of the ASEAN community. MRT World is excited to be a full supporter of the Thai-ASEAN chairmanship. Keep up to date on ASEAN 2019 movement with MRT World.
Once again to our program, we are still with Mr. Vithaya Punmongkol, the Deputy Governor of Mass Rapid Transit Authority of Thailand, MRTA, who will lead us to experience unique and intricate designs of the four stations in the extension that can be described as a visit to a small museum or art space.
Okay, let's get on board.
Okay, you're going to take me there. Where? We start off?
Samyon, Sanam Chai, Wat Mangkon.
Right.
I think that's beautiful.
Isn't it? You like to see? Come on. Now, we have the coin ready. So, we need to go
another
to...
Another one for me, please.
Okay. Yeah. Both of us have the coin. Now we choose a place, right? How do you do that?
We
go to
the place.
The place.
Go,
yes.
And then the machine will tell you the amount to pay. But today we gonna go for free.
Okay.
So no amount shown.
Yes. We only have opportunity very few days for free.
That's right.
Okay. So we have to go to point A or we go to the middle.
I think we go to Sanam Chai first.
First Sanam Chai. Yes.
And
Mangkon. So we should press Wat Mangkon or we have to press one each?
If you want to go out to Wat Mangkon, you have to
press Wat Mangkon.
The farthest one.
Okay, so should I?
Sure.
Press it. Wat Mangkon.
Hey.
Yes. And then this is the key, this is the coin to Wat Mangkon. Okay, how about you, sir? Are you using me?
I go for another one.
Okay. There you are. Okay, so, and then?
We go in.
We go in there, okay.
The gate.
Yes. Ding, ding, ding.
The security gate.
The security gate.
Get the thing to
be so you have to check. See, security is needed. Thank you.
We good.
Okay.
Go to the gate.
Now?
Just touch your coin.
Over here. Say welcome. Wow. Mr. Deputy Governor. This is a real splendid. And I, you know, you have get a feeling of the Emperor Buddha. You are like you're in a
Thai temple.
Beautiful. Who is a designer?
Yeah, this station we have national artist in Thai architecture.
Thai architecture.
Professor Pinyo Suwantiri.
Oh, yeah.
It's very honorary for us to have him design his interior for us.
Well, the designing, is it every piece? Or he designed just this pillar should be here, this one should be red, this one should be white?
He has done magnificently everything.
Every detail
is very interesting. I can't remember all of them.
I get good pimples. You know, when you enter, this is Sanam Chai.
Sanam Chai. Right.
And you get good pimples, you know, when you walk in here. And I really love to interview some of the foreign people. Sometimes if we have an opportunity, I like to see them, how they feel about it. Because Thailand is not something not to forget. Once you are here, you remember the Thai people, hospitality. You smell the smile of Thai people. You will also get, wow, look at this. No, when you're transferring and all that, yeah. Okay, so let's go next.
Thai people
else?
Should be very proud.
Yes, very proud of that. And the lighting and all that, beautiful. So that end is a walking into that, right?
Yeah. He designed the ceilings. The ceiling.
Maybe we can walk this.
More than normal.
Yes.
And the color shape on the ceiling, and also the columns, the border, the wall. See the
look
wall,
at that.
The and also the
maybe
floor.
We can this side. Look at the wall and gold color and all that. So all along will be like this,
the decoration,
right?
Along the beam.
I like the lighting. You feel like you're. Oh, we've seen that. It's with a very old style.
He mixed the red shade himself.
Well, for our audience, you may not know because this is not red, but there is
it
a chart.
Good.
There's a kind of the olden and Thai historical color. And they mix up with certain woods, I think.
Yeah.
They use the woods for making mixture of this beauty. You can never find it. You go to any place to find one color like this.
But
it's
this
difficult.
One, we apply the color on the aluminum.
Oh, it is
really.
So.
It's not wooden. It's
it is so. It's
because
aluminum.
It has to be not non-combustible.
Safety underground. But people are not supposed to smoke here. Not allowed
to smoke, but if there are some smoke, we can notice that. And we have enough protection system to get it
off. Mr. DG, sir, tell us right here what don't and do not do when you are entered to this place.
In terms of safety.
Self-safety?
I have to tell about the when you ride a normal train, you can carry, you can do whatever you want.
Okay.
But in terms of safety, we don't light fire. We don't light the cause of fire. So if something that may be cause of fire, that should not be allowed. But if you have to, check care very carefully.
So this is the advice from the Deputy Director General of the MRTA. So it's time for us to move on.
Let's go.
Director General here, Deputy Governor actually, Deputy Governor here of this MMTR. So tell us about this. This is the first time here?
No, this is the second time.
Why do you have the second time?
Why? Because I live here and I travel a lot, so.
Uh-huh.
And now I want to go to Bang Khae to look the station there, go over the sky train. I'd like to see that.
Maybe we like to hear about the decoration and the design.
This is the only station I see. It's very nice, very beautiful. Yes, I like it. Yeah. Different from the other stations. Very different.
Really? Yes. Yes. So have you experienced such beauty like this in any other country?
No. Only here.
Yes. Yeah, very good. Where are you from?
I'm from the Netherlands.
From the Netherlands. Very good. So you like it. But it's the second round of your trip.
I live here.
You live around here? This area? You. Don't tell me your Thai. Okay, thank you, sir.
Of Wat Mangkon, Kamarawa.
of cloud. Normally we have a lot of cloud above cloud, so I think some of them go inside the station. I think this one is the most for the extension part.
Part, we have
four beautiful underground stations. Wat Mangkon, Sam Yod, Sanam Chai, and Isalapa. So I think it's worth visit these four stations.
And as for me, this is some educational tour given by, led by Deputy Governor of MRT. It is something very astonishing, very impressive, and unbelievable that the station for traveling, you know, the train station, is so beautiful, so authentic, and so something to learn about. So I would like to take this opportunity to say thank you very much for your taking me around, and thank you so much.
Thank you very much for visiting us, and I hope everyone would visit us once.
We are ending up our program with thanks to Mr. Vithaya Punmongkol, the Deputy Governor of Mass Rapid Transit Authority of Thailand, or MRTA. So thank you so much, Dr. Kha.
Thank you very much.
We are ending up our program and looking forward to see you, and I hope you enjoy the show. And thank you for watching Thailand Today. Hope to see you again. Sawasdee ka.